everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I would like to review for you a newly published book that's called The Treasury of Folklore, Seas and Rivers, Sirens, Selkies and Ghost Ships. And this book is kind of an anthology of sorts, and it's a collaboration between Dee Dee Cheney and Willa Winsham, authors of A Treasury of British Folklore and England's Witchcraft Trials. This book contains folklore about the ocean, the seas, any kind of body of water from around the world. I gathered from the acknowledgements, it's also a result of the hashtag Folklore Thursday, which kind of runs on Twitter, and people submit articles to folklorethursday.com. where they kind of collect folklore from around the world about different topics. So this one is particular to the oceans or any kind of body of water. Before I mention anything else, I will have to say that this is an overview. So if you're looking for an in-depth book on any one of these topics, you probably could find it. But if you want to use this as a sort of springboard for your research and just start here, I think it's a good beginning. It amalgamates this research and mythology from all around the world. So some of the things you would find in here are kind of the famous mermaids, the sirens from the Odyssey, Little Mermaid from Denmark, including kind of excerpts from different stories or the entirety of Hans Christian Andersen's fairy tale. You'll find things about the Kraken and Maui. You'll find things about Atlantis or other lost cities, like apparently Germany had an Atlantis of its own, and it was called Veneta. So some of the myths covered in here are very particular to a location, and they'll say, oh, you see these two rocks over here? Well, there's an etiological myth explaining how these came to be, and it'll go into the details of this love story and tragedy and heartbreak, and how out of sorrow these two people became these stones or coral. It also looks at ghost ships. So from the Flying Dutchman to the Mary Celeste. Now, I recently mentioned on this channel the book Ghost Ship, and that book is entirely about the Mary Celeste. That book goes into the details of absolutely everything and anything you need to know about the Mary Celeste. Whereas here we kind of get a paragraph. One of the legends that I really enjoyed was the one about Selkies. This is kind of from the northern parts of Scotland. So the theory is that there are these wonderful, attractive and luring women, kind of like sirens or mermaids, and they're known as Selkies. But they usually hide inside the bodies of seals. But if you catch them without their skin on, or you manage to hide it before they put it back on, they will have to stay with you. And a lot of men were kind of waiting to trap a wife like this and to keep her for life. And there are so many legends and stories. Sorry.
Cthulhu!
There are so many stories of what could happen or how women would stay with these men on land and bear them children and then eventually find the skin and go back to the ocean. I have to admit that I was greatly entertained by this image of just kind of a very attractive male Selkie just sneaking away in the seal skin. I want to know that there were a bunch of men and women back in the day who just sat there by the shore staring at seals like all day, hoping one of them would take off their skin. The image of that is just hilarious to me. The magnitude of these stories can go from as big as ocean tales and sea stories all the way to wells or individual waterfalls. So for example, the Maid of the Mist is in here. She's a Haudenosaunee or Mississauga legend and has been kind of embodied in the mythology of Niagara Falls, and at the moment the Maid of the Mist is kind of the little boat that people go on there if they're tourists, but that's included in here as well. There are mythologies about singular wells or singular rivers, including some from mythology like the River Styx. There are so many myths about anything to do with water in this book. So if this interests you at all, please do take a look at it. It just got published. I was looking for this, so I came across it by accident because I was looking for a book kind of highlighting legends and myths of the sea. Not much to say about the actual writing in itself because it's brief and to the point, so I think the mastery of this book comes in the artwork and the collection of it all and putting it all together, which was done masterfully in my opinion. It is very short. I read it in one sitting. It was really fun. I'm going to link this book and everything you need to know about it down below. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!